Well, this is the final video about Unit 11 and about the course. In this video, we are going to work about the International Poverty Tax, or the difference between among the rich and poor countries. This relationship born from the asymmetric relationship among the countries in the world. For example, rich countries import goods and services from the countries in the third world. Food prices cheap and for other goods and services with higher prices. On the other hand, the poor countries import goods and services with high prices and export goods and products with low prices. So countries with this kind of change or relationship, this country become more rich and the poor country become more poor. These relations among rich and poor countries are known as north and south relations, or as we say, center-periphery relations. First of all, north and south relations. This term don't divide or set the world of the country by Ecuador. Is more a geographical division about the quantity of the power of the economic service or the immigration or the another situation relation with the capital world. If you see this picture, you can see the rich country in dark green and the poor country in green more. These countries are the first world and these countries are in the third world. Center periphery relation or core periphery relation, you could read this possibility, is relation with the situation between the center, economic center in a country and periphery. But this situation is common in the first world and in the third world. If you see the next picture, in this one, you can see the relation and resource and the second photo, you can see the situation in the first world and in the third world. For example, in the rich country or in the first world, the center produce about 30 or 39% of national incomes. For example, USA, the richest 20% consume the 60%, and the poorest 20% only consume rivers. This is the tradition that say that 80% of the global resources are consumed by the rich 20% and the remaining 80% must be do with the 20% of the resources in the world. On the other hand, in the periphery, the third world, in the poor country, center is lower than the first world. For example, 10% Latin American to 48%. For example, Colombia. This is the situation in relation with the USA again. Rural areas, workers, farmers, poor, poverty, 10%. In Latin America, 1.6% of total national income. In USA, or in the first country, or the rich country, 10% is more or less 2.5% in the national income. For this question, the gap on poverty in the world, current times grow and rich countries become more rich and poor countries become more poor. This is the end. What's your opinion? Do you have any questions? No? Okay.